In this video, we're deriving a really useful relationship for doing calculations in atomic physics, and that is HC equals about 1240 eV nanometers. So if we take the product of Planck's constant and the speed of light, these are both given as rather crude approximations, we want to show that that product can be changed into units of eV nanometers, and we get about 1240. In part B, we show why it's so useful to have this constant memorized. It makes a lot of the calculations we do in atomic physics very quick. So I'll start by looking at the product of Planck's constant and the speed of light, just in the SI units. And the first thing we notice is a factor of seconds cancels out. And then we start multiplying by conversion factors. So I have joules in the numerator, and I want to transform those to electron volts. Well, I remember that one electron volt, so that's the change in energy for an electron passing through a 1 volt potential difference. That's 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 joules, and I'll post a link to the video where that was derived. So my joules are gone and transformed to eV. All I have to do now is transform my meters to nanometers. I need a factor of meters in the denominator. And every meter is a billion nanometers, or 10 to the ninth nanometers. So we've transformed to units of eV nanometers, and when I crunch the numbers, I get actually 1,242 eV nanometers. But in my classes, I typically use the approximation 1,240 eV nanometers. Now, the reason this is so useful is because of questions like we have in part B. I'm told I have an ultraviolet photon with a wavelength of 121.6 nanometers. It's very typical to get wavelengths in nanometers. And this is actually the Lyman-alpha line for hydrogen. In other words, it's caused by the transition from the first excited state down to the ground state for hydrogen. So I'm looking at a photon with a wavelength of 121.6 nanometers. And I'm trying to figure out what's the energy of this thing. And I remember the energy of a photon is given by HF. But then I remember I can relate the frequency to the wavelength of the photon. And this is just from the wave velocity formula, where the wave velocity is found by multiplying frequency and wavelength. Well, in this case, the wave velocity is the speed of light, c. So c is equal to f lambda. That means f can be written as c over lambda. And look what happens. My energy formula is actually hc over lambda. So there's that product, hc. Once you have this convenient constant memorized, 1240 eV nanometers, and you can use 1242 if you want to be a little more precise, I can just plug in the wavelength in nanometers. The nanometers cancel, and the energy of this photon pops out in electron volts. And I get roughly 10.2 eV for this photon, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.